Hello everyone! I have been building an animal print themed house for a sim, her daughter, and their cat during the month of August. I decorated each room individually on my shorts, and now we're going to be putting the house together. I went for a modern and expensive style since I decided to make this into a penthouse apartment. The textures and decorations reference several different animals, most of which are wild. I included an office, as well as two bedrooms, two bathrooms, a kitchen, a dining room, and a living room. Each room has a different color scheme, but they're all equally bold and fun. If you'd like to watch each room coming together, I'll have a playlist of those shorts linked down in the description, but in this video we're just going to go ahead and start assembling this home. So when I started putting this penthouse together, I only had a vague idea of how I was going to do the floor plan, because I knew I wanted it to be 2 stories high since I was going to place it in Ciudad Enamorada, and those penthouse lots are smaller than the ones in San Myshuno. So I ended up with a house that was kind of wide, and much larger than the sum of the rooms that I had decorated originally, and the living room I had designed became a TV room because I decided to add a formal sitting area in the entryway. But what I did was that first I decided to separate the rooms that were going to go upstairs and the houses that were going to go downstairs. And I did know that I wanted to have the kitchen next to the dining room, and everything else was just, it wasn't as important. So I also ended up having the office downstairs, and I made a new bathroom, and the bathrooms that I had built originally, and the bathrooms that I had already done ended up both being upstairs. So at first I was thinking that the office was going to be next to the kitchen and the dining room was going to be more towards the entryway, but I ended up swapping those around, and I also wanted to have like a very large staircase, so that's what ended up determining how the layout was going to be on the downstairs. And I think that it worked out pretty nicely. I also knew that I wanted to have the elevator, maybe. At first I thought that I wanted it to be inside the house, but then I decided that I wanted it to be right next to the entryway so that you would come upstairs into the patio areas. I thought that felt a bit less invasive, and it also allowed me to have a bathroom in that space. So I ended up having like a bump out for the elevator, but at first I thought that I was going to have the bathroom next to the kitchen, and I think it all changed when I decided to have the wide door on the entryway, so that definitely made it so that there couldn't be a room right next to that space. And yeah, I ended up not having the house be as wide as the actual lot, but I decided that that space was going to become more of like an outdoor eating space with a tiny garden, so I think that worked out pretty well. And I also decided to copy and paste this bathroom and eliminate the shower because I didn't think that a shower was necessary in this level, and I wanted these bathrooms to be pretty consistent in style, so they do share several of their fixtures and everything, although they are all a different color of the same, or a different swatch of the same wallpaper. But then on the upstairs, I decided that I had a bit of a problem choosing where to have the bathrooms, so that's when I ended up making the bump out of the elevator a bit more prominent, so that I could have the second bathroom in there, and in front of that I placed the child's bedroom, and then the main bedroom is going to be on the other corner, and the bathroom is right next to it. And I made this interesting sort of little hallway, so that the bathroom would be more private. And I did try to eliminate that wall instead of being a hallway, having a bit of a larger bedroom, but it didn't really work the way I wanted it to, and I ended up deciding to have that area to be like a tiny sitting area, kind of a weird transition space. And I did end up having like a bonsai tree and the kitty litter box, because when I was taking screenshots I realized that I didn't have a litter box anywhere, so I think that worked out pretty well. But now I'm just messing around with this bathroom and everything, and it actually allowed me to have a very very small laundry room inside of this penthouse. And I did move things around a lot, so I did cut most of that out, but I think that I edited it in a way that it still made sense, or that it would still be understandable because it really did take too long, and I was getting kind of frustrating watching it back, and it was just a lot of back and forth, and it just didn't make much sense. So what I ended up doing was having the bathroom pretty much the same way that I had it originally, and then this door leads you into the laundry room that is right behind the elevator. And this was the swatch that I decided to go with. It's a darker blue, and I just really like how this snakeskin wallpaper almost looks like tile. I think that is the only one of these wallpapers from Lovestruck that made sense to me in this context of a bathroom. And then I just moved around a lot of these windows. I added a few extra windows, and I just made sure that everything lined up inside still, so I ended up having to rearrange a few furniture pieces, and I think that this result was actually better than what I had originally, because I did think that the mirror in the child's bedroom was a bit strange, so I ended up having it on an area where there was a bit more space, and since it was a bit cramped where the mirror was, I swapped it out for this trash can, which is a pretty small trash can, so that trash can fit in there perfectly, and it didn't look like it was kind of out of place, and I think that I usually had a trash can like in a corner of my room, everywhere I've lived, so I just thought that it made sense. And I also added a few more of these windows in the main bedroom so that this wall wasn't so blank and I could have like this window design that I was going for, the large window in between the smaller windows, and then I just fenced in this little terrace space, and then I was trying to find a fence for the rest of the outer space here in the penthouse, and at first I was thinking I was going to use one of the fences for rent, but then I changed it for a glass fence, and eventually I ended up with a black metal fence, so yeah. The fence was kind of a journey, but I'm pretty happy with how it turned out, and I also really liked how this landing space ended up being, because it was pretty large, so I knew that I was going to be able to fit some of those items that I normally don't have. And I tried to go with this very large cat tree, but I just felt too big, so I ended up going with the medium-sized one, and I also added a card table, which I never add, so I was pretty happy that I had one of those in here, and they also added like this tiny storage cabinet with a mirror from Forent, which I thought worked in this space, and I'm sorry for this space having so much cheetah print. It doesn't stay like this. I eventually did a better thing with this, and it only ends up being in one of the walls, but at first I just wanted something on the walls. But I did use these chairs from Moving Hangout, and the tapestries also from there, and they have like these birds and feather patterns and things, so I thought that was pretty cool with this house, because I already had so much cheetah and zebra print and like tiger print and everything, and so I thought that this made a lot more sense, and this is when I decided to paint most of these walls black. Which is something that I really enjoyed, because it makes the black furniture sort of disappear, and the doors as well as the archway, so I also painted this wall on the kitchen black. I thought that made a bit more sense. Also, it looks like it's continuing, like it's the same wall from your side of the kitchen, so that it doesn't look like so strange when you are in the living room looking into the kitchen. And I also found this swatch of this rug that I am using everywhere. The rug is from City Living, and I thought that the gold swatch was too good to pass up on, so I decided to include it, and I also used a different swatch on this couch that I was already using in the TV room, but I also think that it's different enough so that it's still interesting to use, and I don't know if I will ever use that swatch again. I do really like that couch, but the animal print swatches are a bit too much for me, so I was just happy to be able to use it. And I also decided to have this, like, mirror furniture piece here next to the bathroom, and I added this these flower pots, they are like, they're from Cats and Dogs, and I think that they are so cute. And I was thinking that this family had a cat, so I went with this watch that was closer to the cat that I had chosen for them. So I thought that was a cool little detail to include. And I didn't upload this family to the gallery, although if you would like me to do that, I can do that, since I am also going to be uploading the finished product to the gallery. So you can tell me if you would like to see that. And yeah, I'm just adding some more decorations into this space. I knew that I wanted a mirror next to the doorway and some more like artwork on the walls. I had separated some of these items into a separate room that I eventually eliminated. You must have seen it. And I'm glad that I found a space for most of the items that I had separated into that space. I wasn't able to include the love seat from the pastel pop kit, the one that has the cow print, but I was able to include a lot of these paintings and some of the rugs and stuff that I had in there, so I thought that was pretty successful. I also decided to include this other cat tree into this space because I was already using those chairs, the tiger print chairs in the dining room, and it felt a little bit repetitive to have it there as well, especially since I also have them in the TV room and I added an extra one into that weird hallway space, but you will see that in a bit. So I thought that having the cat tree in that space that was so full of silver print made a lot of sense, and this is that that hallway that I was mentioning. I used a different swatch of this chair so that it isn't as repetitive, but I don't think I had ever used this chair, and so I was just excited to use it. And this house is so chaotic that I thought that it was good if some of the things repeated so that it looked a bit more cohesive. But I do know that it really is very chaotic. And but anyway, this is going to be that outer space in the upstairs. I decided to have a telescope and some gardening stuff in here. I also added the romantic blanket, and I picked this swatch that has animal print, but it isn't as loud as the other swatches. So yeah, I ended up having a very plain exterior in a sense. I went with a lot of black stuff in here, and yeah, I did tone it down a lot. I still used plenty of like colorful items, like the stuff that I was using from Blooming Rooms, like this hanging pot thing and the bigger hanging pot thing. I went with a fun swatch on those, and yeah, I just felt that the outside needed to be a bit less intense. But that's the other thing that I was mentioning, the hanging pots, and I just really liked that it fit perfectly right next to the elevator and the laundry room. I'm very happy with that, and I also decided to have a pool. It ends up being a hard pool. I thought about having a different shape, but I don't know, the hard just made sense to me. This house is so tacky that a hard seemed like the best option to go with, and here I was thinking that I was going to be using a glass fence, and I don't dislike the glass. I thought about keeping it, but I wanted to have this like more decorative fence from City Living so that I could have like a separate garden space. I wanted to have a different fence next to it, and since the height of those fences wasn't the same, I just thought that it looked a bit weird, so I ended up replacing that fence for the glass fence for the metal fence. I also decided to have this sort of like custom pergola thing, or awning. I don't really know what to call this, but I made it using a low-lying fence. It's from Strangerville, and I also added like some trim so that it looked a bit more finished. And I do wish that it had like actual shadows on the whole thing, not just like on the edges of these. But I think that it looks nice. I think that it matches designs on the metal fence that I was using upstairs. So I thought that it was fine, and I also decided to have this garden area a bit smaller so that I could have like an actual door that led into this space, and I could have this picnic table as well as a grill. And I also wanted to have some lounge chairs right next to this. I'm using the ones from Base Game because they had flamingos, and I still wanted to use as many animal things as I could. However, I ended up deciding not to keep the kiddie pool, even if it did have some fish. But I just couldn't find a decent space to have those. And I did want to keep the swings. They are a fun item. I just like the swings. Though I confess that at the end of this build, I was getting a bit tired. It was nighttime and I have been so busy, and I've been sick and everything. So I was a bit, I wanted to be done with it at the end. And, I forgot that I wanted to add a chess table outside. But that's a very easy thing to add, and there's plenty of space if you want one. And I was just focusing on having like this water tower space on the upstairs, because I just love that this world looks like the city I live in and the cities I visit here in Mexico. So I wanted to do this thing in which you have the water towers kind of hidden into their own little tiny room on the rooftop, and it's not accessible, although I did end up having a door that led into this space. And I also included the fancy fire alarm on there, so it does look like it could be accessed, and I thought that it looks like it makes sense. You could add a ladder somewhere in here, maybe from the balcony, or maybe next to the elevator, but I just, as I said, I was too tired, and I would only add one of those if I was thinking about adding some solar panels or something like that. But now we're just going to be working on this garden area, just adding some landscaping, and then we're going to be adding the little fountain from Lovestruck and some outdoor lights from the Jungle Adventure game pack, and that's going to be pretty much it for this video. Thank you so much for watching, I hope that you enjoyed it. And I'm just really glad to be back building and recording and everything. It really was a very busy month, and being sick wasn't great for my productivity, but I'm very glad to be back. If there's anything you would like, anything specific that you would like to see me build, I would also love to read about it in the comments. Oh, and I forgot that I did add some like floaties into the pool that had animal designs there from Forens. But yeah, that's everything. Thank you so much for watching. And I hope to see you again soon.